Hello and welcome to worship with members of Haywards Heath, Hurstpierpoint and Burgess Hill Methodist Churches. We gather together for worship on this, the 16th Sunday in Ordinary Time. And as we begin our worship, we use a prayer from the Methodist Worship Book appointed for this day. So let us pray. Eternal God, in Christ you make yourself our guest. Amid all our cares and concerns, make us attentive to your voice and alert to your presence, that we may prize your word above all else. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And so we sing our opening hymn, Jesus Calls Us Here to Meet Him. So we come to our two Bible readings, and today they both come from the Old Testament. Shortly we will hear a passage from the book of Genesis telling part of the story of Jacob. But first we hear from the book of Psalms, and Psalm 139. O Lord, you have searched me and known me. You know when I sit down and when I rise up. You discern my thoughts from far away. You search out my path and my lying down, and are acquainted with all my ways. Even before a word is on my tongue, O Lord, you know it completely. You hem me in, behind and before, and, excuse me, and lay your hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me. It is so high that I cannot attain it. Where can I go from your spirit, or where can I flee from your presence? If I ascend to heaven, you are there. If I make my bed in Sheol, you are there. If I take the wings of the morning and settle at the farthest limits of the sea, even there your hand shall lead me, and your right hand shall hold me fast. If I say, surely the darkness shall cover me, and the light shall become night, even the darkness is not dark to you. The night is as bright as the day, for darkness is as light to you. For it was you who formed my inward parts. You knit me together in my mother's womb. I praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Wonderful are your works, that I know very well. My frame was not hidden from you when I was being made in secret, intricately woven in the depths of the earth. Your eyes beheld my unformed substance. In your book were written all the days that were formed for me, when none of them as yet existed. How weighty to me are your thoughts, O God! How vast is the sum of them! I try to count them. They are more than the sand. I come to the end. You are still with you. Oh, that you would kill the wicked, O God, and that the bloodthirsty would depart from me. Those who speak of you maliciously and lift themselves up against you for evil. Do I not hate those who hate you, O Lord? And do I not loathe those who rise up against you? I hate them with perfect hatred. I count them my enemies. Search me, O God, and know my heart. Test me and know my thoughts. See if there is any wicked way in me, and lead me in the way everlasting. And so we hear from Genesis chapter 28, beginning at verse 10. Jacob left Beersheba and went towards Haran. He came to a certain place and stayed there for the night, because the sun had set. Taking one of the stones of the place, he put it under his head and lay down in that place. And he dreamed that there was a ladder set up on the earth, the top of it reaching to heaven, and the angels of God were ascending and descending upon it. And the Lord stood beside him and said, I am the Lord, the God of Abraham your father, and the God of Isaac. The land on which you lie I will give to you and to your offspring. And your offspring shall be like the dust of the earth, and you shall spread abroad to the west, and to the east, and to the north, and to the south. And all the families of the earth shall be blessed in you and in your offspring. Know that I am with you, and will keep you wherever you go, and will bring you back to this land. For I will not leave you until I have done what I have promised you. Then Jacob woke from his sleep and said, surely the Lord is in this place, and I did not know it. And he was afraid and said, how awesome is this place! This is none other than the house of God, and this is the gate of heaven. So Jacob rose early in the morning, and he took the stone that he had put under his head, and set it up for a pillar, and poured oil on the top of it. He called that place Bethel. But the name of the city was Luz at the first. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. And so we are going to sing our next hymn. It is There Is No Moment of My Life, inspired by words of the psalm that we have heard today. So let us pray. May the words of my mouth and the meditations and reflections of all our hearts and minds be guided by you, O God, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. In May 2019, Helen and I went on holiday to Whitby. I must confess that it is always a bit of a dilemma about whether to go to church while we are on holiday. But on this trip, we came up with a solution. We bought a small carton of blackcurrant juice and a bread roll, and we went to Whitby Abbey, sat among the ruins near where the altar would have been, and celebrated communion together. It was one of those moments of being so aware that we join in worship with the saints of old, as well as the saints of our current age. Although we all know that God is everywhere, Celtic Christian writers speak of these moments and times as thin places, those places where the gap between heaven and earth seem narrowest. In many ways, this may be an obvious thin place. It is a place of beautiful surroundings, amongst a place of worship where generations of Christians gathered for prayer and acts of devotion. What is more, we had gone with the attitude of encountering and worshipping God. Of course, this would be a place where that gap between heaven and earth would feel thin. I wonder where your thin places are. Are they buildings or are they outside? Are they places where you have encountered something of God on your own or with others? Are they places you have been to repeatedly or only the once? Thin places should be treasured within our hearts and within our memories, that they may continue to encourage us on in our journeys, and we may continue to discover God in those places, even if we only go there in our minds. Our readings today are both about people being surprised by the discovery of a thin place. Jacob was fleeing from his brother, whom he had just tricked out of his father's blessing, a momentous thing in those times and in that culture. He had to leave in a hurry, and no doubt his mind was all of a whir. He lay down to sleep in a land that felt foreign, far from family, and far from where he thought God dwelt. Yet it was in that night's sleep that he discovered his thin place, in a location and at a time when he least expected it. As David pondered on his experience of God, he was surprised that there were all manner of thin places. In fact, there was nowhere he could go where God wouldn't be present. The Hebrew phrase describing where God was when appearing to Jacob is unclear. It can mean that God stood over Jacob, but it can also mean, as we heard today, that God stood alongside him. Maybe this points to part of the surprising experience of a thin place. You can't ever quite put your finger on where God is. All you know is that God is definitely close at hand. Both Jacob and David discovered in their thin places that they were known far deeper than they ever thought possible. Jacob had been a trickster all his life. People could never be sure that what they saw was really who he was. Maybe Jacob himself didn't know fully who he was. Yet in that encounter, he discovers one who does know him. David acknowledges that God knows his innermost parts. There is nothing hidden from God. At the moment when that all feels too daunting and they may wish to run away, they both also discover that God not only knows them deeper than they thought possible, but God also loves them more than they thought possible. So may we treasure memories of thin places that we carry in our hearts and minds, and treasure those who may have experienced them with us. May we return to those places, either physically or in our minds. However, may we also remember that every moment and every place has the potential for being a thin place. We don't necessarily have to prepare for it, but God can break in when we least expect it. In those moments, may we also discover that we are known and loved more than we ever thought possible. May those moments stir us up to keep walking the path of life with God, until we reach journey's end. Amen. Before we sing our next hymn, we're going to have something slightly different. My wife Helen has prepared a video of photos with music accompanying them that all point to places and times that have been thin places for her. And so I encourage you, as you look at the photos and hear the music, may it all encourage you to reflect on where your thin places are. And at the end of that time of reflection, we will then sing our next hymn. Thank you. we come to our prayers of intercession. And there is a response when I say the words, God of mercy. I invite you to respond, hear our prayer. God of mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for all who have fled their home. We pray for those who have left abusive households with a mix of trepidation and liberation. We pray for those who have left their homeland because of persecution, climate change, or poverty. We pray for those who have left their home but have nowhere else to go. As we pray for all those in these desperate circumstances, so we also pray for charities and organisations who seek to support them. God of mercy, hear our prayer. We hold before you, loving God, those who try and flee from pain and memories that haunt them. When it feels as though there is no way out, may your light and hope break into their lives. God of mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for all who are fearful of being known, or feel as though they could never be loved. May your love surprise them and heal them. God of mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for places of worship and thank you for the opportunities they can give to open all who seek to discover how thin the gap between heaven and earth really is. God of mercy, hear our prayer. We thank you for all those saints who have gone before us. May we always know our deep connection with them in you. God of mercy, hear our prayer. All these prayers we offer in the name of Jesus, who taught us to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and for ever. Amen. And so we sing our final hymn, Guide Me, O Thou Great Jehovah. So go from here, open to discovering those surprising thin places where you are this week. Go knowing that you are known and loved far deeper than you could ever imagine. And go with the blessing of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, with you and those whom you love, living and departed, this day and forevermore. Amen.